Blackstone Audiobooks presents
Vincent van Gogh by Julius Meier-Graefe. It is subtitled A Biographical Study and is translated by John Holroyd Rees. The book is dedicated in gratitude and admiration to the America and the Americans who made this edition possible. Translator's Note. Julius Meier-Graefe is an author who has made a unique position for himself, not only as a critic, but by the achievement of this book as a writer of fine prose. The forcefulness which lends character to the original text has no precise equivalent in English prose, because the author has employed what can only be termed slang, and he has relied largely upon a manner of expression which depends for its effect upon a subtle play of German words. His finest passages reveal their merit as much in what the author has left to be understood as in the actual phrases he has written, and he has created a new literary phenomenon by a vitality of rhythm which defies precise analysis. The factors here referred to combine to render adequate translation peculiarly difficult. It is not the intention of the translator to praise the merits of the original text in such a way that his praise shall thinly veil an apology for his own shortcomings, but it is proposed to give the reader a clue to enable him to enter as fully as possible into the spirit of the original text. Translation in the ordinary sense was clearly impossible, and the only solution I could find was to read the original until I had virtually committed the book to memory. I then took notes in English as if I were attending a lecture, and having completed my notes, closed the German book and wrote the first draft with the aid of my notes only. It had been my intention to write a very free translation, but when I reread the original by the side of my manuscript, I was amazed to find that what I had hoped would be a free rendering was almost an exact transcription of every phrase and every word of the original. I was horrified, but all efforts at freedom of rendering proved a failure. Eventually, I came to the conclusion that an English ghost of the spirit of Meier-Graefe had taken possession of me, and that whatever the demerits of my manuscript may be, the method I was forced to adopt reflected the most essential characteristics of the original better than any other means at my disposal. Such pleasure as the reader may derive from the book is due to qualities in the original so powerful as to break through the obstacles my translation presents and to the help I have received. My particular thanks are due and tendered warmly to Ronald H. Boothroyd, whose special revision of the present edition represents, in my view, a substantial improvement upon the original draft. J. Holroyd Rees, Rapallo, February 1933. Introduction. This is the story of a man who lived from the year 1853 to the year 1890. The events of his life, his actions and his words are not imaginary but real. His name was Vincent van Gogh, and he was what you call an artist, a description that may mean anything. In this case, it means a drama, a queer, eventful history full of strange happenings. The action here related came to an end only a generation ago, although it seems as remote as the legend of St. George and the Dragon. The charm of our story, like that of any other, depends upon its presentation. The motives of our hero must appear, why he acted as he did, and the manner in which he expressed himself and his ideas. In the present case, the story is not the work of any alien hand, but was in the main left by our hero himself. Acted the drama, wrote down most of it, and himself, through the medium of a transparent symbolism, pointed the moral. The text of the play, his letters to his friends, and especially those to his brother, have been published long ago, both in the original and in an English translation. Their author, needless to say, never desired either to enact or to write this drama. In fact, he longed only to live a quiet life, enduring not too much sorrow and enjoying some measure of happiness. He failed of his intentions as signally as he succeeded with his play. The function of the present author has been confined to purging the play of superfluities and to filling out the gaps. The lines of the letters and what is written between them are the threads of the story. The rest has been gathered from the symbols already mentioned, which are the works of the painter. No attempt has been made to make a...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.